Hello, my name is Elia. I'm a project officer at the MAGS. In this tutorial, we would like to guide lead partners in filling out their project's progress report in Bamos Plus. But this is only one step in the whole reporting process. If you are interested in understanding all steps of the reporting process, we recommend that you turn to the tutorial on the introduction to reporting. This should give you an overview of where to find the forms and what process to follow. So let's start. Overall, one of the main pieces of advice we can give is to read the guides included in the progress report form in Bamos Plus. For every section in the progress report, we have drafted a description of the type of information that you should include. That said, let's go through the different sections together. Tab 0, Introduction, includes information on the version of the application form on which the current report is based, as well as two ticks, one concerning the completeness and validity of the contact and bank information, and one concerning the availability of the signed partnership agreements. Tab 1, Overview Progress, includes a space to enter the link to your project webpage, a space to share with us your main achievements since the beginning of your project, a space to indicate any challenge you have faced during this reporting period. If you are not facing any challenge during this reporting period, please mention it, as the section cannot be left empty. The last space in this section is to describe how your project helps to implement actions in the EU strategy for the Baltic Sea region policy areas. If this is not applicable to your project, you would need to indicate it as well. Tab 2, Work Plan. In this section, everything is structured according to the work plan that you have developed in your application. From the main work plan section, you can navigate to each work package and to all groups of activities. Here, you can also see the overview of the timeline that was agreed for your activities. The symbol next to the work package sections indicates if this section has been completed or not. First, access the general work package section by clicking on the name of the work package. Here you will have to report on engaging your target groups in the whole work package, so across all groups of activities that are part of this work package. Then, by clicking on the single groups of activities, you can access the reporting section for each group of activities. Here, you will have first to indicate the status of the group of activities in the drop-down menu. In the guide, you will find further explanation on what the different status options mean. Status errors are frequently made, so please be careful in selecting the appropriate status. This is important because the selected status influences which other sections will be visible for you. It is quite straightforward. If there is no activity planned in the reporting period, according to the timeline agreed in the application form, there is nothing to write. You only need to select the corresponding status, no activity planned. If the activities have started and will continue in the following periods, in line with the agreed timeline, it means they are ongoing. You can also indicate this status if you start your activities earlier than planned in the timeline. The activities are delayed in two cases. Either you should have started the activities according to the timeline, but you have not yet, or by the end of the reporting period, you should have finished the activities according to the approved timeline, but the finalization is delayed for some reason. When you indicate this status, a new section will be available in which you will be able to explain the reasons for the delay, its consequences, and how you intend to remediate these. If you have finalized the activities in this group of activities during the current reporting period, you should indicate the status finalized. You can only indicate this status if you have indeed finalized the deliverable or the output resulting from this group of activities. In the following progress reports, you will still be able to provide updates on this group of activities in case it is relevant. For instance, if additional activities have been implemented even though the output or deliverable has been completed. Moving on to the next sections, once you have indicated the status of the activities. In order to help you draft the report, there are sections that are automatically copied from the application form. From the second period onwards, there will also be sections copied from the previous reports. For the section Implementation in Current Reporting Period, we invite you to read the guide and to watch the introduction tutorial for general tips on how to write and what to include. In the section Challenges, you should share with us any information on challenges that could lead to delays or deviations in your planned activities. This can be related to difficulties in involving target groups, issues related to cooperation in the partnership, or that you are struggling with some planned activities. In all of these cases, it is better to be open and to communicate about challenges early on, so that, if necessary, acceptable solutions can be sought jointly with the MAJS. Here, it is important to note that you are contractually obligated to deliver the outputs that have been agreed on in the valid version of the application form. If at the end of the project major deviations from what was planned can be observed, cuts to the budget can be made. So, it is in your own interest to communicate clearly and early on about developments in your project, especially if they could impact your outputs or solutions, and how they will support the target groups that you selected. A similar status section needs to be filled out for your deliverable or output resulting from the group of activities. Here you have three options. Either you have not yet finalized your deliverable or output, then the implementation is ongoing. Or you have finalized it, in which case you will have to fill out additional sections, for example, describing the final deliverable or output. But please note that if you indicate the status of your deliverable or output as finalized, you will not be able to make any changes to these descriptions in the following progress reports. In very rare cases, you can indicate that the delivery of the deliverable or output has failed. Of course, in this case, you should have discussed and agreed with your project and finance officers at the MAJS before reporting on it. As mentioned, depending on the selected status, you will see that some other sections appear. For example, for both finalized outputs and deliverables, you will see description of the finalized deliverable or output, topic of the output, tags to be selected. In the case of outputs, additional information will be required, such as links to the output or its elements, target groups and uptake of the solution presented in the output, durability of the output. The guides attached to each of these sections specifically explain what information needs to be included. Here as well, the text of the application form is visible to remind you of what you planned. The following three tabs will only appear in your midterm and/or final report. Tab 3, Indicators, only in final report. In Tab 3, you will need to report on the output and result indicators. You will only be able to review the information under this tab during your final report. For each of the indicators, you will enter the value achieved at the end of the project and the corresponding explanations. In case of deviations to the estimated value, you should explain the reasons in this section as well. The section Summary of the Survey's Outcome refers to a compulsory survey on the increased capacity of organizations outside your partnership. You will receive access to this survey in due time. The survey was designed to be as simple as possible. Lead partners are responsible for disseminating the survey to their project partners, which shall then collect survey responses from organizations both within and outside the partnership. The lead partner is responsible for providing a brief summary of the outcomes of this survey. Tab 4, communication products, only in midterm and final reports. This tab will only appear in your midterm report and final report. So, you will report on your communication products twice in the project lifetime. In this section, you will need to paste the links to the communication products you have prepared and published on your project page. You will get an extra field for an explanation in case you need it. Depending on whether it is the midterm or final report, but also depending on the project type, core or small, you will have to provide links to certain communication products published on your project page. As you know, the communication products are the following: revised project summary, project story, two quotes, a picture, video or audio product, and for core projects and platforms only, information on the contribution to an EU-wide event or campaign. For more information on the communication products, please check the program manual. Annexed to the final report. This section will only appear with the final report. The following information will be needed in this annex: the lessons learned from your project implementation, the strengths and weaknesses of your project, what you would have done differently, and so on. Your contribution to the horizontal principles that you select in the application form. The follow-up to your project. New activities that have been inspired by or initiated during the project work and will be continued after its implementation. The cooperation with other projects and initiatives during your project. And positive change to the region generated or initiated by your project. Tab 5, overview of finalized outputs and deliverables. This section will be filled in automatically as soon as outputs and deliverables are finalized. Tabs 6 to 10, these sections will be filled in automatically on the basis of the financial data included in the partner reports. Please review the plausibility of the data. Check whether the partner report inputs were imported and they are correctly displayed. Please add comments where required, for example, in the Section 7 Spending. Tab 8 Investments is only visible for core projects which planned investments. Tab 10 Contracts is also for core projects only and shows large contracts above the EU threshold. For further details about the financial reporting and management of the partner reports, please watch the tutorial Partner Reports. Tab 11, Imported Partner Reports. This is the overview of the partner reports you have imported for the given reporting period. Tab 12, Submission. This section allows you to submit the progress report. Do not forget to press the Submit button. Congratulations, you have made it to the end of the reporting form in Bamos Plus.